Week 18 of B2VB Basics Flourish Edition brings us a bump chart. Now, if you don't know what a bump chart is, this is a great opportunity to learn. It is essentially just a line chart, but instead of showing the actual values, you're just going to show the ranks, the changes in ranks over time. And, you know, sometimes you just want to do that. If you think about a golf tournament, for example, maybe you just want to show change in ranks over time. So what we're going to do in this one, I haven't actually made this chart yet. I've prepared the data. I have not dropped it into Flourish. So this is going to be as live as a recorded video can be. So let's take a look what we've got. Here's the data. We've got the TIOB index. I don't actually know what the TIOB index is, but it's popularity of programming languages updated monthly. And so what we're going to have is a programming language. We have a bunch of different programming languages. We have the rank in each month, the percentage, and the date. Let's go over to the data. So here's the data, and I just need to reshape this data. So this is the raw data right here. And I'm going to create a line chart in Flourish. And the way you need the data to be set up in Flourish is not what, how the data, the raw data set up, right? The raw data is set up what I would call long, so that you've got the programming language, the rank, the raw percentage, and the date, right? So it's essentially, you've got, for example, C right here for all of the different months, and then you've got C plus, right? And then you've got Fortran, and so on and so forth. And the way Flourish wants the data is it wants it wide. So it wants the date in the first column, and then it wants a separate column for each programming language. So I need to go from this long format to a wide format. So I do that pretty simply just using a couple of formulas. I'm just going to put together here the date and the name of the language. So I'm just going to use a little concatenate function to do that. And then over here is my wide data, and I'm just going to basically just merge the date and that name so that it matches what's going to be in my match column over here in column E. And then I'm just going to use a little series of XLOOKUP functions to pull the data over here. I could have used a couple of different functions. There's a new VStack function I could have used, or an HStack function, I guess, in this case. I just did this. It was a little bit easier. I could have even copied and pasted if I want to, but, you know, this is fine. So I pulled the percentages here, and then I pulled the ranks down here. So this is the rank column split out in kind of this wide format. So I have the date and then each programming language and then the rank in each month. So that's the data. So I'm just going to copy it over here, and I'm going to move over to Flourish. I already have my folder set up for week 18, and I'm going to hit new visualization. Now, there isn't a, as far as I know, a bump chart template. It's just a line chart. So remember, it is just a line chart. What we're creating is just a line chart, but it's a line chart of ranks, not of the actual value. So Flourish isn't going to care. So let's go to the line chart template. That's nice. That's set up. I'm going to go in the data tab. I'm going to clear all these data out and drop in my data. So a little paste, and it's going to set up. So I've got the date and then all this language. Now it's just holding. I don't know what it's looking, why it's choosing these. So, but I want all these in here. So I'm just going to go B to N. We'll try that again. B, N. There we go. All the data. Let's name this one bump chart week 18. We've got the data in. It's all numbers. Let's go over to the preview. And that doesn't look right. Okay. Like I said, doing this live. So let's see what's going on here. Let's look at the dates. 1/1/23, 1/2. So this is not reading the dates in right. Let's go back to data. Right, because this is the kind of the difference between European dates and American dates. So it generally reads this in as, instead of month, day, year, it's, which is how the American is set up, it's reading it, I think, as day, month, year. So we're just going to change that. And you can just go, you just scroll a little bit here to month first, so month, day, year. I'm going to hit apply that, and now I should get it right. There we go. All right, that's looking good. Okay, so first things first, we need to flip this y-axis. So let's go to y-axis, and let's just say flip it. Lovely. Let's change the min and the max to go from 0 to 11. So I want to have a little space there at the bottom. I also want to change the ticks in the labels there. So let's style that up. And I think I can change this to custom. And have to figure out how to set this up. So I think I just want to do, I think I have to do one every line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's see if that works. There we go. Look at that. Looking good. Let's see what else. What other changes? I'm not sure I love the swirliness on the lines. So in the lines dot areas, I change that to straight. Maybe I do like the curve. Yeah, I kind of do like the curve. Okay, I'm going to keep the curve. Yeah, we're going to keep the curve. Okay, so we've got Python's always number one. I don't need these labels here, these little line labels. So let's go under labels, which is here. And I think there's a thing where we can turn off the lines right here. Turn those off. We don't need those. We could change the colors here. I don't know. I mean, I personally kind of like the default Flourish colors. You know, there's a kind of different one here. I don't know why there's two that are so similar, but I'm going to leave this. I kind of like it. Let's change the x-axis labels. I mean, if you've watched enough of these videos, you know that I hate that this is arranged at that 45 degree. So let's see if I could force it to go to zero. And I'm going to make it just a little smaller. See how much smaller. Oh, there we go. Not too much smaller. I mean, that's not too small. I guess I could even change. I could change the format. Actually, I do need to change the format because you can see here of the dates. So this says January 9, 2023, January 10, 2023. That's not right because it's the other way. So I need to actually go back and I need to change this. So, because I didn't change the preferred output. So you probably saw that. If you saw that, if you're looking at this, you're probably like, hey, he missed that thing. Well, let's go back and fix it. And actually, if I do this way, that might allow me. There we go. That's a little bit bigger. I actually don't think I need the day there. But let's see if I can go back to one. No, see, I don't think I need the day. So let's go back and change it because it's always the first. So let's just say month and year, and I can probably do that. So down here, yeah, April 1972. Let's try that. That's not going to fit. I think if I did the three-letter format, I mean, this is what it is to learn a new tool. There we go. Let's try that one. I think that one's going to work. And I'm going to make this a little bit smaller to get it to fit in there. Going close. And it's doing this 0024. Oh man, there's some number formatting going on in here. So I think I have to go back to the data maybe and change the date. I'm not exactly sure why it's doing, because it's not going into the 2000s for some reason. So that's a little, oh, you know what? What if I just did month year like that? No, see, then it's doing 01. So this is some weird date stuff that's going on here in Flourish. Oh, because that's month. Sorry, that's month day. So I want month year. Let's try that. Although I don't like that leading zero. Yeah, see, it's still not doing that 2000. So I don't know why it's doing that. So I have to dig into that a little bit more to figure out what's going on. Let's fix the header here. So let's say most popular coding languages since September 2023. And let's put a little text here that says rank. And see, that's a little far away. So I think I actually want to change my y-axis instead of going from 0 to 11, make it 1. That'll tighten it up a little bit. That's what I want. And we go back to header. And I think that text is okay, but I want to make it maybe just a little smaller. Yeah, that should be good. And I'll add a footer later. I think other than that, I could fix the tooltip here. I think what I have to do really is, and I'm not sure why, so let's actually do this. So I'm going to add a new date. And I'm not exactly sure why this is not showing up the way I want it to. So maybe I don't need to. Maybe I could just do it in Excel directly and get the full date here like this. Okay, so that looks now like I have the full year. And if we go back over here and paste that in, now let's see if we've got the right date. Okay, we're getting very close, very, very close. So the input format, see, it resets. That's the one thing. Really frustrating. So month first, and then what I want to come out of it is like, let's say the month as a number and then the year as a number. So I want this to be 0472. Here, 1972, like that. Let's see if this works. Ah, we got it. All right. We got it, folks. We got it. I'm gonna go back and make this a little bigger. Okay, so it's got to be at 0.9 is gonna get it to fit in there just like that. And again, I might want to change some of these lighter colors, like this one and the yellow. I'll probably and maybe the green are a little bit harder to read. So I could go in and come up with some other colors. And let's just add one more thing. Let's just add the footer. So we're gonna say back to Viz Basics with a two, not an at, VB, week number 18. And let's go get the URL. Come all the way back over here, copy it, go over here, paste it, and we've got it right there. And let's publish that thing. And I'll share it with you, and you can play around and enjoy it and make yourself a bump chart in Flourish. So make sure you subscribe to this channel, learn more about data visualization, learn more about presentation skills, Excel, Flourish, PowerPoint, Tableau, all the things that you'll need to be a great data communicator.